are rules by the joint services has impacted negatively on the work of the power company. Adam Harris reports.
The backlash of an action by the joint services 2 weeks after Donna Herod was shot dead in Buxton on September 4th last has impacted on the Ghana Power and Light. Staff members of the power company simply cannot access meters in the village.
That could have been used in certain areas, the excuse of persons to attack them.
I've advised them to be very careful. In addition, we have recognized that certain areas who, for reasons, are using the same approach. I mean, that happened in Buxton. But in other areas where people would really don't want GPL to come around, they will use this as a kind of a way to get the meter readers not to do their work.
Members of the joint services impersonated staff members of the power company to enter homes and to launch raids into the community. And despite the reports of the impersonation, GPL never voiced a protest with the police or with the joint services. Barrett Dindian, the chief executive officer, said that consumers should demand to see some form of identification. Members of the joint services had gone to Brush Dam in Buxton as GPL workers and had entered homes. By the time the villagers realized something was wrong and began to retaliate, the bogus GPL workers radioed for backup. Since then, there has been no light bill collections in that community. Chairman Ronan Ali said that the community is among 12 targeted for extensive disconnection in the coming weeks. Adam Harris, Prime News.